The Kentucky Wildcats have been the prohibitive favorite to win the NCAA basketball title for most of the season. Tonight, they tried to make that dream come true. The Wildcats trying to give Coach John Calipari his first national title. First half, Kentucky on the break. Marcus Teague to Terrence Jones for the emphatic finish. Jones finished with 9. Same half, and Michael Kidd-Gilchrist finds Deron Lamb for the tough reverse and 2 of his game-high 22. Kansas trailed by 14 at the break, but in the second half, Thomas Robinson with the follow to cut their deficit to 10. But in the end, Kentucky had just too much for Kansas. Coach Cal and his troops get it done with the 67-59 win. Now, since rumbling surfaced 2 weeks ago, the Clippers players were disenchanted with head coach Vinny Del Negro. The team has won 5 straight. Tonight, they were in Big D to face the Mavericks. First quarter in the Mavs, Vince Carter was stripped by Caron Butler. They had to break Griffin for the flush and foul. Griffin, 15 points, 16 boards. The Clips were up by 12 at the half. Third quarter, and Randy Foy heats up. He hits a triple here. Behind the Kenyon Martin screen, he fires and hits from downtown. To the fourth quarter, unbelievably, no one was to guard him, and he hits another triple. Foy had 28 points on a career-high 8 three-pointers. And the Clippers have their first 6-game winning streak in 20 years with the 94-75 win over the Mavs. And tonight in NBDL action, the Jam, having already clinched a playoff spot, apparently forgot to show up tonight as they were easily defeated by Dakota, 111-92. The Condors hosted a year-end party tonight for the public at the Bakersfield Marriott Convention Center. The team didn't make the postseason, stopping a string of 7 straight playoff appearances. However, tonight was all about the appreciation of the fans and the city of Bakersfield, who continued to back their team through a truly tough campaign.
Credit goes to them, you know, to be able to stomach a losing season and to still support us, because, to be honest, in today's world, no one likes to lose or likes losers.
I think it's a great idea. It's going well. Everybody's enjoying it. Well, I am anyway. It's kind of fun watching them out in with the public and everybody enjoying themselves. The young people are here having a good time. I'm having a good time. I'm talking to you.
San Francisco Giants right-hander Matt Cain, due to earn $15 million in the final year of his current contract, signed a 5-year guaranteed extension today for $127.5 million, making Cain the richest right-handed pitcher in baseball history. The 27-year-old Cain went 12-11 last season with a 2.88 ERA and has thrown at least 200 innings for 5 consecutive seasons. The Indiana Pacers forward Reggie Miller headlined a 12-member class to be inducted into the Naismith Basketball Hall of Fame in September. Also getting the call to the hall were Coach Don Nelson, who spearheaded the Warriors in 2 different stints for 11 years, and Warriors and Lakers forward Jamaal Wilkes. Miller played more games for one franchise, the Indiana Pacers, than any other players except Utah's Karl Malone and John Stockton, while Wilkes played on NBA champion squads for both the Warriors and Lakers.
Look, it's a humbling experience, obviously. You look at all the men and women that are on this dais and the ones that are out there watching us and the ones that are at home. To be a part of this exclusive club, it's pretty special.
So I'm one of those rare guys that throughout his life has been able to do what he loves to do, and I've done it my entire life. And now to be inducted into the Hall of Fame is like the cherry on top of my ice cream.
All right, a lot going on tonight. Thanks,
Preston. There is. You're welcome.
All right, we're coming right back.